we are. Day number two. So we went and had something to eat last night in Carentan. And we're back here at the digs. All just got set up, loaded up. So we're going to see a few sights today. I think we're due some rain as well today. Later this afternoon, so we're going to do more of the local sights today. We found there's a little bar around the corner, so we got LB. Piggy. Yeah, so we're going to that. Plan is that we might go and see Utah Beach. We'll see. If not, tomorrow's looking like it's going to be a good sunny day all day, so we might do local today. Get some of the museums in today if it's raining, so at least we're indoors, and then tomorrow go out and do all the other sightseeing. So we're just getting loaded up. Gonna get some supplies out. The one thing what was surprising here was it was a Friday and 7:30 everything closed. There wasn't an off licence. So in the end we found a petrol station. At the side of the petrol station there was a little kiosk what did pizzas, and he had a little fridge with some beers in. So we managed to, we wiped him out, we took all of his stock. So at least we had a few beers last night. And we had a good night. Went to bed. Piggy introduced me to something new. He listens to rain sounds on his phone. Sends him to sleep. So we put it on last night. And we went to sleep listening to the rain. But Piggy did say I am the Snorax, that I was snoring a bit. So watch when you get loaded up. Let's get out of here. Let's go and see our first sight. See you soon.
Well, morning, boys and girls. Day two of our Normandy France trip 2020. You wouldn't think it's the 25th of July. I think it's the 25th today. You wouldn't think it's the 25th of July. Look at the weather. A bit overcast this morning. All the boys are assembling up. We're getting ready to go out. We're going to go to a little village up the road. I can't remember what it's called now. I'll put it up on the screen anyway. Where there was a massacre, where the Germans massacred all the members of the town in the church and the priests and everybody for helping out the Americans when they landed. Then we're going to head on over to Sainte-Mère-Église, have a look over there at one of the museums, the Airborne Museum. And take a look at the parachutes hanging from the steeple, which would be good. And then from there, possibly over to, well, we are going to go over to Dick Quinter's memorial for Easy Company, 506 101st Airborne, from the Band of Brothers. Look at that, and then head on over to Utah Beach and have a look over there as well. Craig doing his vlog. There he is, our illustrious leader. So without further ado, we'll get saddled up and crack on. Catch you later. See you in a bit. Bye.
Well, so here we are. We are ready for day two. We've got all the boys lined up. We got the bear. We got Viper. We got Goose. We got Piggy. We got Pablo, we got Iceman, we got Albie, and we've got Victo already, ready and waiting. So let's get the bikes on the road and have some fun. Right, can I hear all the girls?
Hell yeah!
Yep. We got everybody?
Stuart's and his fine fiend.
Jobs are good, and jobs are good. And well, then, boys.
Do you want to go in front of me, Vic, or what? Or do you want to go behind me? Do you want to watch my nice? Oh, you like to watch my back, don't you?
Yeah, I'll go behind you, Goose. Ugh. You going through?
No, I'm waiting for Craig. He's going first, a pigeon.
Yep.
I need to be in the middle because Need guidance.
Are we ready, boys?
Yeah, there, but.
So where are we going? Straight.
Yeah. We're going left.
Left.
Right.
Oh, that's a bit of breeze.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Here we go!
Yeah, so all these old the old houses around here, all the village got together and did what they could to hide the American soldiers from the Nazis. And that's then why the Nazis killed all the village.
What list are these houses we're riding through now?
I think if you obviously the old ones, I mean obviously some of these are new builds.
Somebody fancy one in front, innit?
Okay.
There's a thing, look, the 507.
Clear.
Yeah, there's a memorial up there. What, there's a sign, which means people can pull out from the right.
Thank you. Well, is it a big heron? A massive big heron. Just flew in.
Turning left. Just watch it up here, it's a bit
mind the gravel.
Is that a church up on the hill or is that a house?
This is it, that's all that's left of the church.
Yeah.
Lovely gravel.
Where are we going to park?
Blinker's still on ice, man.
Couldn't park here, couldn't we? And just line them up.
Get that for a pad.
Oh, that's nice, isn't it?
Yeah.
Wow.
Beautiful.
Yeah, so the rest of it just got blitzed, the rest of the church. I wonder if you can go in, because the memorial's inside right. It. Is the gate
down
open?
Down this end, isn't it?
There's a gate here. Entrance.
Yeah, it's a gate here.
Yeah.
There you go. Here's the information. This was the church before.
In the early hours of D-Day, 182 men of the 507th Parachute Infantry Regiment were dropped in Normandy, 20 miles from their target.
We could see in the distance a church steeple with a cross on it. And I figured that had to be a village on high ground, so we started to make our way towards this village.
The landmark that drew John Hinchcliffe was the cross on the 12th century Catholic church in the village of Graignes, a small community of about 200 dwellings. In the first light of dawn, small groups of soldiers made their way out of the marsh and into the village.
Let's go.
By 10 o'clock, 25 paratroopers under the command of Captain Dave Brummett arrived. Major Charles Johnson led another group, which also included Lieutenant Frank Norton and Captain Abraham Sofien Jr., the battalion surgeon. By the afternoon, 182 Americans had gathered in Graignes.
It wasn't long before somebody got too close and the shooting started.
In examining the identification papers of the dead German soldiers, the Americans made a worrying discovery. An entire Panzer Grenadier division, comprising thousands of German mechanized infantrymen, was very close to them. But suddenly someone burst into the church.
Miss Bazire was a woman who lived right by the church with her children. She saw the Germans coming. She ran to the church and told us to run away. The Germans.
Lookouts in the belfry saw a daunting sight. The Germans could be seen setting up two 88mm artillery pieces. The Germans opened fire on the church. Captain Sofien chose to stay behind to care for the wounded, hoping they would receive honorable treatment as POWs. But tragically, the killing had only just begun. Unfortunately, not everyone in Graignes was so fortunate. Once the Germans had overrun the village, a group of SS men entered the priest's house. They knew the church had been of enormous help to the Americans. The SS shot Father Le Blestier and Father Le Barbachon. Even the housekeepers were not spared. The wounded paratroopers were about to receive the same fate. The enraged German soldiers stormed the first aid station in the church and forced the wounded and their doctor, Captain Sofien, outside.
Those five men were bayoneted and shot and dumped in the water.
Another group of the wounded was frog-marched south, out of the village. The Germans commanded the men to dig a pit before they shot each of them in the head. A total of 44 villagers were rounded up and interrogated by the Germans as suspected collaborators. They were threatened with execution if they didn't surrender the names of all the villagers who had helped the Americans. The following day, the Germans ransacked Graignes and set fire to the church. The blaze spread to the rest of the village. 20 people were executed at Graignes. 7 paratroopers were killed at Hemover. In all, 32 paratroopers lost their lives at Graignes. The paratroopers, the priests, and their housekeepers were not the only lives lost at Graignes. 28 villagers died during the battle. After the war, the ruins of the church were turned into a memorial where the names of those who gave their lives for liberty are forever enshrined.
So obviously they killed the priest on the steps of the church. So from the top up there, which is where the paratrooper was, in his observation post, looking out. Yeah. And he spotted the Germans on a motorbike and so he got and killed them. Yeah, the memorial's inside here, guys. Still got all its bullet holes in the wall here as well. In memory of the citizens of Graignes and the American soldiers who gave their lives in defence. Well, look at that, they just killed all the villagers. André Luce. Franco-American. Yeah. So I take it the steps were here. This must have been where they killed the priest. And that is, I imagine, is where the paratrooper was. On to the next point.
Whoa, sounds nice, Victor.
About me or the bike?
Both.
I'll go at the back. So I'll get you all on camera.
Who's leading?
Okay.
Where are we off to now?
Up to Sainte-Mère-Église, where the parachute has got stuck on top of the church.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh,
okay. And there's a museum there as well.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, ready when you are, boss.
On the right side of the road.
I was just thinking that, because I was going to say, what are you doing?
Just open this jacket, I've got a full sweater.
I'll tell you what, it looks good this does from the back.
I do. Oh, sorry.
Clear.
Clear. Still clear. Just watch that grate on the bend.
Oh.
Clear.
Yeah, you're clear, Craig.
Nice one. Cheers, bro.
Just the weather's picked up a little bit.
Well, I'll tell you what, boys. I will be looking forward to this weekend, but really unsure what to expect. And I'll tell you what, just going there, then, Christ, that hit me like a ton of bricks.
That looks good, that, to see you all go around the corner.
I can't talk, I've still got American hard gum in my mouth.
Haven't seen many sheep yet, have we?
You're missing
them. They sent all the sheep to Wales.
You're diversifying, Vic.
Yeah, well, I'm half goose. Welsh, so I do like seeing sheep.
I thought that when I saw your velcro gloves and your back.
Vic! Wow. Vic. I thought by now you'd learn just to keep your mouth shut.
No, I'm obviously not very up with it, am I? I'm not very quick on the uptake. I forgot your face last night, Goose, and that cow was mounting that other one, and you looked straight at me. I thought, what's he going to do with me?
You've got that animal instinct.
He was giving you a wink, Vic.
You think I'm Dr. Bloody Doolittle or something?
Actually, well, you mentioned horses, cows, sheep. You're missing the sheep. I start to worry about you.
What's the actual name of this town, this village where we are?
Tribow.
You got Rockside at Road.
Oh.
What's this car, boys?
I can't work this junction out at all.
No, it's telling me.
Have we got right at one?
Do you want to come up here?
It's telling me to turn right here, Steve.
Let's go, Victory. Car's coming. Vic, on the other side of the road. Vic, on the other. Oh, there. Okay, you. My God, man.
Oh, thank you.
Is this 30 through here now?
Yeah, 50k I think.
50k, right.
Or 30 mile an hour.
Well done, Goose, you've got me back.
Of course I have, my man. We've got to get everybody's back, because you know what? We might all do it, haven't we?
Yeah. I'm going to see if I can keep this American hard gum going until we get there.
This is a beautiful area we're in.
It's lovely.
Is Piggy still here? He's quiet.
Ah, Pig's still here, brother.
Good man.
Is this the one we go through where it drops down to 30?
Yeah.
I just put him first.
We seem to be the only ones that are doing 30. I wonder if it means it's only 30 when like school's on or something.
Just means everybody bought locals.
Yeah.
They seem to rip through.
Clear.
It's all clear. Keep going.
Clear.
Lovely jubbly.
I am liking the roundabouts.
Yeah. Nice, aren't they?
More natural, isn't it?
Yeah. Dead Man's Corner Museum.
Oh, that's Dead Man's Corner.
Yeah, Dead Man's Corner Museum. With a tank.
That's where, that one there, Stu, was where The American soldier was shot dead in the tank.
Right, yeah.
And he was sat up sticking out the tank, and he was there for weeks, just sat there. They just left him in the tank.
Hence, Dead Man's Corner.
Dead Man's Corner. Yeah, they kind of used it as a waypoint if any when soldiers was going anywhere. They said, yeah, get past Dead Man's Corner.
That's a bit of tarmac.
Smooth as a baby's ass.
Oh, I love a bit of new tar. Oh, their motorways are just brilliant, aren't they?
It's the pigster. We got the goose. We got motorway. And we got the crazy bear. You all good, LB?
Yeah, I'm good. Craig, is that you behind me?
Yes, mate.
Do you want to take us in, Skip?
No, mate, carry on, you're fine.
You sure?
Yeah, you're good, brother. Airborne Museum. There's the church with the parachute on it.
Oh, yeah.
And this road is called Route de Eisenhower.
Route de Eisenhower.
Let's just hope some stuff's open, eh? Okay, hopefully we can all get our bikes on the left-hand side here, look.
There's bike parking over there, by the look of it. Yeah. So, Albie.
Yo.
The parachute is what landed on the church.
Yeah.
Did he kill anybody, or did the Germans just kill him as soon as I saw him?
Do you know what? 100%, I couldn't say.
But have a look.
I couldn't say.
I mean, if anything, just double them up. There he is.
Pardon me.
Oh, me crack-a-demus, mate.
I want to get down on the end.
Put him long ways, like that one. If you want, like put it like in front. You know what I mean?
I say double them up.
Yeah, thick. Just go up against there. Oh, I'll tell you what, Fick, just do what you want. Which way are you going? There.
Do you think you could just pop back to the thing for me and get me out of the jacket?
Well, I'll tell you what, mate, just because I love you now. Look at the Jeep.
When we was here last time, it was literally full of them everywhere.
I'll tell you what, I'd love one of them.
Nearly every other vehicle was a military vehicle last year.
Here we go then. I just made it to Sainte-Mère-Église this year. Didn't make it last year, me and Pablo, but we're here now. Here's the famous church with the paratrooper stuff on it. Can you imagine, eh? Poor so-and-so being stuck up there thinking, how the hell am I going to get down? Even if I cut my straps, it's still a long way to fall.
The paratrooper of the church, John Steele. John Steele was born in Metropolis, Illinois on November the 29th, 1912. Volunteering for the airborne troops, he became part of the 505th 82nd Airborne. He landed in May 1943 in North Africa and jumped in Sicily in July 1943. In the night of the 5th to the 6th of June 1944, John Steele landed on Sainte-Mère-Église and hung from his parachute on the steeple of the church. John was freed from his harness by the German soldiers posted in the church. Taken prisoner, John Steele escaped and joined his troops. He jumped on Holland and fought in Belgium and in Germany before being sent back to the United States in September 1945. John Steele came back a few times to celebrate the D-Day. He died of an illness in 1969. So we survived it. We'll be right back.
Okay, I'm going to pop in the church and have a look. Take a look at the stained glass window. Wow, there it is. Look at that. Wow, how beautiful.
Are.
It is us, really. Look,
it is. It is.
We did it, mate. So he didn't get shot up there. The Germans took him down, kept him prisoner, and then he managed to get away. Crafty Hank. Good on you, mate. Imagine coming back here and looking at that statue, thinking that was me. Wow, blows your mind. So every cloud has a silver lining. Cool. Beautiful. Angels of the sky. Protective angels of the town.
I don't want that much.
It's always my fault, Nick.
You wanted donged.
Yeah.
Hey, Stu.
Who said that?
Me. Who? Stu. Vic.
Oh.
How come you didn't bother with a GB sticker?
I've got one.
Oh, right, okay. Oh, right, fair enough. I'd be a good copper, wouldn't I? I'd pull you up and you'd say, there it is. I'd say, you're taking the...
What are them lights for? They're like, just, didn't it like them? Or them in the day?
No, they've been seen in the dark.
No, I mean, they're like a specific daylight or thing, like that.
Everybody ready?
Yep. Go on, Stu.
Now, this is trying to figure out where we are on the car park.
We're just going round again, I mean, so.
Well,
look at these pigeons.
Let's go round again. Average white man.
Let's go, man.
Who sung that song?
I was expecting you to break out of song.
Let's go round again.
Average white man.
That's it. Turning left at the end. Look at that. It's a bit mean, isn't it?
You thought you got neck ache on the blade?
Look at that pig.
Well, the hell that is.
Tell you what, whoever found that little shop for the lunch, good show. Well sorted after that. That was Viper's Discovery. Good boy.
It's quite reasonable and all.
Here they've got right hand junctions, they've got right of way, so just keep your eyes peeled. Oh, look at some of these old houses. Lovely place.
That's nice.
Oh no, Vic. Oh no.
Oh, oh, no. Somebody's going to get that cool. In a minute.
He's happy now.
Exactly.
Don't do
can hear it.
Oh, it's chasing man.
Which one takes your fancy, Vic?
It's on the end of my boot.
Vic's leisure centre here.
Thing is, he balked it. He balked it, my bike walked back.
I'm not going to say nothing about anything.
God, you!
Turning right. It's a car coming if you... If you're quick, you'll get out.
Yeah, if you're quick.
Hang on, car
coming. Clear, clear.
Still clear, Stu. Go on, mate.
Clear ice, clear.
Shame you couldn't have experienced it last year when we came, with all the military vehicles on the road.
There's a memorial there.
Eh?
There's a memorial there. Is that the Airborne Memorial? That was the crossroads, wasn't it?
I didn't hear you say again, mate.
Turning left.
Yeah, when we came last year, all these little country roads, it's all full of... But I keep saying all the military vehicles.
It was like going back in time, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. Yeah.
Oh, hold on. Yeah, left. Everybody here?
Yep.
Now.
D913, it's on this road. Stuart.
Yep, I'm here.
Clear, guys.
Clear.
Here it is.
Clear ice.
Here it is. If he moves, we'll get all the bikes and that lined up. Wonder when he's gone. Really gravel again. Lovely.
There he is. The man himself.
come on, boys. Someone dropped it.
Can I get in there, motorway?
I'm off the post.
No, keep going, keep going.
Go on, you're
right. Keep going, keep going. Keep going. Bit more.
Bit more.
Oh dear.
It's near enough.
Bit, stay there, I'll come the other side.
Right.
I'll come to your right, you'll be able to move into the left then.
Alright.
It'll be too far, you're swinging otherwise. Craig, I'll. Yeah. Getting a bit tighter, we should be alright, shouldn't we?
Yeah, you've got them all right. Right, you ready, brother?
Yeah.
That's it, lock it over. That's it. Keep coming, keep coming, keep coming, keep coming. That'll do ya.
Right. There you go, mate.
Santa.
Keep coming, keep coming, keep coming. Bit more, bit more. Keep going. Oh dear. You alright, leave her in gear. Got her in gear. You got it, it's all yours now. Keep coming, mate. Keep coming, keep coming, keep coming, keep coming, keep coming. Oh dear.
Yep.
You've got room to get off. You've got room to get off there, Vic.
No.
I'll get off. Hang on. I'm going by there, Vic.
Better go out a bit more.
Will you get off that now?
Yeah, oh, mate, look at the...
Come on, Vic. Leans.
Bring yours. Come forward a bit.
Hang on.
Tuck it.
Yeah. You're way on the...
I'll go with
come over this way. Come over to me. This way. That's it. Then straighten up.
So, put right hand down now.
So try and get them all as close as we can.
We might have to get
one outside.
Yeah, get some there, yeah, maybe get right. Some at the side. Yeah.
Alright.
Come on, Pigster.
Is there
any bars?
Yeah. Yeah.
You can get another one on the side here. Yeah. We get two more in here.
Come on, Pig.
We can put the others in here, look, one, two, three, to the front.
Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. That'll do, yeah.
Come around and put it in here. Just back them up in the gaps.
See, that yours goes right over, doesn't it?
Pablo.
That's right, yeah. You should get them all.
Get it. Get one in the front here, yours. Or one that one, or there. It's up to you. This way a little bit.
Wars do not make men great. But they do bring out the greatness in good men. Richard D. Winters, Easy Company, 506th Parachute Infantry Regiment, 101st Airborne Division. Major Richard D. Winters. Dedicated 2012 by the World War II Foundation, along with our French allies from the Utah Beach Museum. Support of grateful citizens of the village of Sainte-Marie-du-Mont.
There you are. Like a little cross, there's a little memorial to say thank you to the Grimmers and all the boys, and all the boys that fought in the war for us, and gave us our freedom. So it's a little something we're going to do now. A little folded American flag, military star. Tuck it under his boot. After that, Dick. Hopefully, it won't blow away in the wind. We can always lay it flat after the video of it all. Now,